anything you like. It can be a Land Rover wave, it can be a camp wave, if you like.
Hi and welcome to this episode 6 of Land Rovers Live. As always, I'm Matt and with me, Jeremy.
Hello there.
So it's been a really busy few weeks for us. And for most of you guys out there as well. Where have we been, Jem?
Well, Peterborough.
Yeah,
and you went to the Overland Show as well.
I went to the Overland Show in Stratford. So coming up on today's show, largely we're going to tell you about what we saw at those shows. And
yeah, I like that Peterborough show. It was a nice, friendly show. I was quite impressed with that.
So we'll take a look at those. We'll also reveal the winner of last week's drawing contest, not where we got you to draw, but where we asked you to submit your pictures so our talented artist Ollie Davenport could
draw them.
Yeah. So he's chosen a winner, I believe.
Do you know the name?
I don't know yet.
Oh, good.
I might know a bit later in the show.
Oh, excellent. Well, later in the show, we'll bring forward that exciting bit of news of who's won this excellent prize for a unique drawing by Ollie Davenport.
That's it. And we've also got a new competition this week, have we not?
We have, to win one of the disc locks that we didn't damage. Generous from disc lock. So, and actual fact, it came out top of our review, so it is probably the most effective.
Let's not tell them that. We haven't done the review yet.
Oh, all right. We'll ruin the surprise.
Yeah. Okay, well, yes. Well, we'll see which one comes out on top in our security review a little bit later in the show. What else has been going on?
Well, we want to give our best regards to the chaps going up to Bowden, is it?
That's right, they're going up to Glencoe from Birmingham.
And this is all to raise money to buy a new Defender for the mountain rescue people, whose details.
Yeah, we'll put the links on the screen for that. But that'll be a really nice 2-day. Is it overland or just a rally?
I think it's just a rally.
Yeah.
It's a rally, but it's
2 days from Birmingham up to Glencoe. And they're, as you say, they're raising some funds to buy Glencoe Mountain Rescue, who happen to.
You know all this?
I do know all this.
Oh, well, that's
they happened to recover the body of somebody who...
Well, it was his business partner who had a sudden death on the...
Yeah, so...
It's fortunate, but he's making good of it, which I think is an excellent thing to do.
Yeah, I think so, yeah. So that's a nice thing. That's going on this weekend. And then we've got the London to Brighton run as well, which is also happening.
Is that all Land Rovers?
I think so. Probably. Okay. We'll put the links on the screen and you can have a look for yourself.
Oh, and another bit of news, of course, is the Whitbread Challenge. We wanted to get a bit more involved in these winch challenges because they seem mad. It's basically dangling from trees with winches and things. And we were trying to get into it, and we decided to go and take the weekend off and go down to Wales and film the Whitbread Challenge, which is one of the most respected of these events. Fortunately, it's been cancelled. So if you were also going down to Wales for the Whitbread Challenge this weekend, or 12th, 13th it is, don't. Instead, we've got news, we'll put the link on the page again, of a Woolwich challenge, which is happening later on this month, and will at least fill that hole. So, bad news and good news.
And there was another piece of news, but I can't remember for the life of me what it is. Oh, Paris Motor Show.
Paris Motor Show.
Yes, that starts next week. And we'd like to be there, but we won't be on this one.
Well, we'll send Jonathan and Amy.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, shall we take a look at what we get up to in the shows?
Yeah, let's do that.
We're here at the Land Rover Owner International Show at Peterborough. If you haven't been to this show before, I'd recommend coming. It's probably the best show of the year, so we're going to take a look at what's happening around the show. And as always at the shows, there are a whole host of competitions. This one run by Sealy, you can win over £10,000 worth of tools. If you're at the show, you can sign up here, but for another 7 days until the 28th of September, you can go to sealy.co.uk and enter there. Then, unless you've been living under a rock, you would know about this, the LRM Defender being given away. You can fill in a form here at Peterborough or go straight to the LRM website. We'll put the details on the screen for that, and they're giving this away in about a month's time, I believe. And as well as this, be sure to check next week's show as we bring a great competition, including a giveaway on 1948 original equipment gear, as supported by myself. But coming to the shows isn't just about the competitions. There's a whole bunch of useful products and new and innovative ideas. Like this one we've come across here from Landy Lubber. This is a security padlock, and we've added this to our physical security review, which will be coming up in future weeks. And of course, no show will be complete without all the bits and pieces you need to fix your Land Rovers. And some people choose to actually have their birthdays here as well, like Ronnie Jr. from YRM. We've been here all weekend at the LRO show and we've had a really good time, meeting a load of great people and seeing loads of interesting new products. Don't forget about the competitions, the ones we've put up are ones you can enter from home. Just a week after the Peterborough show, we're here at Stratford for the Adventure Overland show. It's a much smaller show, but it's our last one of the season. It's one we particularly like, because it's not just Land Rovers. You'll see all sorts, from Syncros to Toyotas and everything else in between. The thing that sets it aside is its extensive schedule of seminars.
And be lost in your adventure. It's the most important thing ever. Just be mentally lost. Just go. Just turn off.
A whole bunch of them going on throughout the weekend, from what you need to go wild camping to kitting out your vehicle with expeditions and what countries to go to and which ones to currently avoid. It's also a great opportunity to see how some people have modified their own vehicles, like this 110 Hi-Cap. They've done a really nice job out of the inside, and it's probably our favourite one, which is why we're doing the links from here. As always, if you've got any questions, do tweet us or get involved with us on Facebook and we'll try and find out the answers. Over the coming months, we're going to be catching up with some of the people who we've met at the Adventure Overland show and seeing what they get up to in the actual overlanding life.
That's pretty cool.
So that's a brief roundup of the two shows we've done over the last 2 weeks, and for us, that was our last show of the season. Now, I know this weekend coming up, we've got the Newbury show, and there are various other ones going on around Europe, but we're going to start our show season again next year. Now, coming up now, we've had a look at some physical security products. As Jeremy will tell you, the news for Defender owners keeping hold of their vehicles has been a little bit grim over the last 12 months or so. So let's head over and see how Jeremy got on looking at some physical security reviews.
Unless you've been living under your Land Rover for the last 12 months, you can't have missed the epidemic of Defender thefts. The insurance industry tell us that 20% of these vehicles are recovered, 80% never seen again. That's a pretty clear indication that they're either sold abroad or broken for spare parts. So in this episode of Land Rovers Live, we're going to look at the physical devices you can use. We're starting with the clutch claw, the disc lock, and a little device of our own making, because the best advice is defence in depth works best.
We wanted to include the gear stick lock from Foundry 4x4, or a much more substantial wheel clamp designed for HGVs from Elite Security Supplies, but for reasons of logistics or apathy, we weren't able to include these devices in this review. That doesn't mean the devices aren't any good, just that the respective marketing departments suck.
Now, I'm not going to make any pretense of doing a scientific comparison here. Each of these devices is different, even if their function is all the same, to secure my landing. What we can do, we're going to use the least butch member of our team. Let's have a look. Oh, Amy, you can come and install them for us. And we're going to find a couple of lads from Blackcountry 4x4 who are going to have a go at taking them off.
All right, we've got all our security devices in place. We agreed with the manufacturers. We'll give our gentlemen here from Blackcountry 4x4, Neil and Brett, just 5 minutes to see what they can do. I've got a selection of tools here. What do you fancy, guys?
Well, looking at the first one, being a padlock and chain, there's only one tool for that.
You turn to the grinder.
And that's this
baby. I'll put this back in the boot then, guys. Yeah. Let's get on with it.
Amy found fitting the padlock and chain a little bit tricky. We think this is mainly because she'd just got out of bed. We attached it round the steering wheel, but the reality is you can put this more or less anywhere. Let the battle begin.
Okay. First things, make the noise. Cover that with your hand, don't hear the noise anymore.
Amy's notes about the disc lock were really to make sure you have the right size one for your steering wheel. They do come in various different sizes. But aside from that, nothing else to report. It went on quite nicely. Grinders at the ready. Thank you.
Right, well, we all love to score, so we thought we'd have a little bit of a scientific touch to this and add a few points. I'm just going to add the ones for convenience, which is how easy to carry around in the vehicle. Clutch claw, not so bad really, so I thought I'd give that about 6. Disc lock is a bit of a pain, it's a bit of a thing, so I'm going to give that 4. The DIY chain and padlock, well, you can stick it in the boot under the seat, but it's, you know, it's still a bit of a lump. Probably 5. Okay, and now, Amy, can we give you your points on ease of installation, please? There's the magic pen.
Thank you. So, clutch, claw.
Was that a fiddle?
Kind of. Yeah, I'm going to say 4. Because once you set it up, it's okay. Disc lock, I imagine would be easier if I didn't have the chain and stuff. But 5, it was still kind of annoying.
She's a bit mean with these points.
Yeah. And then the lock.
You didn't like that, did
yeah,
you?
Yeah, no, I don't like that at all. I'm giving it a 3.
Brilliant.
There you go.
Neil, what do you reckon for the security features here?
Okay then. Right. I'd say the padlock, nice little feature with the alarm, but unfortunately all you got to do is just put your hand over it, as you saw, and you don't hear any more alarm. It could be improved obviously by a lot better quality padlock and chain, but it's still going to come off with an angle grinder either way. I'll give that, what do you reckon, Brett?
Not a lot, 3.
3. We'll give that a 3. Where is it here?
Yeah.
This one.
Yeah.
And the steering lock, as you saw, gave us a bit more of a challenge, the steering lock did. The first cuts are done. I think if we'd done the second cuts first, it would have come off a lot quicker. Definitely we could have got it off a lot quicker now we've done it. But I'd say it was the best of the 3. I'm going to give it a 5, yeah?
Should we go for 5? Yeah.
We'll give that a 5. And that's it.
Thanks guys. Out of 30 points, none of these did really well. I suppose the disc lock, because it was the most convenient, the easiest to install, and turned out to be the most secure, came out on top. But to be fair, we did have a couple of hench guys who know what they're doing and they got the right kit. So the best advice is still, if you want to look after your Landy and you can find a way of adding any barrier to somebody who wants to take it away from you, particularly those people who aren't too experienced, the opportunities these devices are still worth looking at, particularly the disc lock. My Land Rover is going to be nice and safe and secure. So we've been told a lot of times, the more devices you can fit, the more time you buy yourself, the less maybe the chance of the vehicle being stolen. But, bugger, should have chained it to a tree.
So there you have it, a relatively comprehensive guide at the look of some of the physical security options that are available. Not bad, eh, Jim?
No, I have to say I'm a little bit disappointed. I would hope that by the time I spend £200 on a Land Rover, I could stop some oiks from taking it in, what, 10 minutes?
Sadly not.
No, so and I'm afraid that's the measure of it, really. There's only one way, and it would appear that if you don't chain it to something permanent, if you have your Land Rover parked outside your house where people can see it and they know where it is, you can't just rely on these off-the-shelf devices. So, and a tip from the guy at Elite Security, and I'll thank him for this, is if you are going to chain it to anything, use 15 or 16 millimeter chain, which is pretty hefty, but it's the only chain that'll defeat bolt cutters.
Well, that is that's good
tip.
Advice, isn't it?
Yeah, good advice. I've never had a Land Rover nicked.
No, I have, lest I forget. What we did find as well, looking through those, was actually, though the products, we showed them to be relatively easy to get off these.
We could have used a better padlock on the chain, it seems that, you know, even some design changes on that disc lock could have made it a little bit more impervious to attack. Mm. But at the end of the day, those blasted battery-powered grinders will get through anything.
Mm. And the guys from Backcountry 4x4 were particularly handy at wielding them as
expert, I have to say.
I wonder where they learnt that. So, a big thanks to Backcountry 4x4 for doing that for us.
I think we wasted an entire day of about 6 of their staff, you know.
Yes, I think so. Mm. But anyway, moving onwards, when we were at Peterborough Show, you found a rather lovely thing going on.
Yeah, a good thing there that we managed to do. Two lads who are taking an enormous trip around West and South Africa, so they're going all the way around the one coast, across the middle and down to South Africa.
Ebola permitting.
Ebola permitting, although frankly one guy's ex-army and the other guy's a BMXO, so I think they'll just chance it anyway. We put them together with a company called TrackIt 24/7, who are going to provide tracking technology, so we will hopefully, when they start in March, be able to follow them every step of the way. And they promised to give us video and all sorts of things. So what would be really useful if we could support them and their charity, which is to raise money for a hospital, I think it is in Malawi. The link again will be on the end of the item. So if you want to get involved, make sure you follow their expedition and see how it might help you plan one of your own.
And that's more or less it for this week's show, but we've still got time for the bits that you nearly gave away earlier.
Yes, the prize.
Yes.
The winner.
Yes.
So, and his name, TT?
Terry Taylor.
Terry Taylor.
So congratulations to Terry Taylor. Ollie will be drawing, he's assured us, over the next couple of weeks.
Well, he will. We didn't check if Ollie can draw water.
No.
But hopefully, no. Terry, he can draw your Land Rover beautifully moving through water.
Yeah. But we'd like to thank everybody who sent in their pictures, and there were some absolutely fantastic ones across the way, and we'll put those on the screen. And worry not if you didn't win this week, because we've got another chance to win, haven't we? We're giving away what?
A disc lock.
Your favourite product from the physical
store? Yeah, it was the one that came out on top, I'm happy to say. And the one we've got from disc lock is not the one that we attacked. So it's a working disc lock.
Fully working, functional disc lock.
As long as you keep it away from Black Country 4x4, it'll be fine.
And you can win this in a fairly typical fashion by now. We would like you to purely share the show, whether it be on Facebook, Twitter, or on your forums. We'll take all those as a competition entry. You can share as many times as you like in as many different places you like. We'll accept multiple entries, won't we?
We'll accept multiple entries, but you only get one entry in the hat. Isn't that right?
Is that right?
Well, normally right, because, well, I don't know, spectacular efforts. If you share it 1,000 times, we'll probably give you a bigger piece of paper.
Yes.
Okay. Or a smaller hat.
Mm. And obviously in our security review, they weren't all the products available on the market. So if you guys think that you've seen something better, or in many cases people take to their workshops, don't they?
Well, I think that's where that giant wheel clamp thing came from Elite. So there definitely are better and trickier ways. And that's one tip we were given, actually, that if you are using non-standard devices, kind of what we were trying to do with the chain, you've got a better chance of defeating those little people because they won't be equipped to deal with the device you've fitted. So by all means, if you've got any clever booby traps or restraining devices, any ideas you've got, let us know. In fact, we're working on one ourselves.
We are indeed.
We are indeed.
It's top secret.
It is. Well, it's already been made, I have to tell you.
Okay. Well, we'll put the links on the screen, but to get in touch with us there on Facebook and or Twitter. And next week, we will be bringing you the weatherproofing, as winter is coming. So we'll have a look at the pitfalls, and we've seen some extraordinarily bad weatherproofing done by.
It's shoddy from a very respectable company as well, yes.
Sadly so.
Yeah.
So we'll be taking a look at how to do weatherproofing properly next week, and I'm sure a whole bunch of other good stuff. But for now, are we guys waving again?
Well, we've happily got 2 weeks, so we should be able to work it out by then.
Yeah, I'm sure we will. Yeah. So bye.
Bye bye.